Well, when I got the news that he passed away, it was almost like a shock to me.
And I tried so, so much to help him make it, but it was his time to go.
Losing a family member is never easy, even if it's a pet.
And I think you come to love them as much as another person.
Ken Weiss comes to this pet cemetery every week. He wants to remember the good times he shared with his three German shepherds buried here.
And that's why I think that in heaven, the pets will be there too, for our enjoyment.
The love doesn't end when the pet dies, and so many pet owners can't imagine an afterlife without their beloved companions.
I just think that when I die, I won't be that afraid anymore because he's gonna be there.
Did you catch this? Huh?
Most religions believe that human beings have souls, a spirit eternal, but whether animals have souls has been a question up for debate. At one end of thought are Eastern religions, such as Buddhism, which say animal souls are equal to those of humans. At the other extreme are faiths such as Christianity, which says that only human souls are immortal.
Thought, and especially reflective thought, is supposed to separate human beings from animals. So once you have this assumption, the argument is very brisk. Human beings think, animals do not think, therefore animals do not have souls.
Ed Galloway disagrees.
I can't imagine that we are so special that we're the only ones on this planet that have souls and they don't.
Ed has buried three bunnies here in the last 4 years. He spends many hours here tending to their graves.
You know, you look at them and you think, who's higher up on the scale, them or us?
They definitely have personalities.
The King family surrounds themselves with animals. A dog, a camera-shy cat, five turtles, even an iguana. But whether they have souls is another matter.
Ah, the soul. I don't know if they have souls. I know they have life forces. I know they have good energy coming from them, but I'm not sure what happens after they die.
Human beings make choices, moral choices, that animals don't. And I see the moral choice as very closely connected to the soul.
We come out here all the time and we feed the ducks and we feed the turtles.
This family says the question is not what happens after death, but rather what we as humans can learn from animals while here on Earth, just as it is with people.
Delicious.
Everything in life is a teacher for our spiritual growth, and that animals are our teachers no less at times than other human beings or experiences.